Hola. So I have tried a couple of times now to record this on my computer, and for some reason the recording keeps stopping and it won't upload. So we're going to try this on my phone. I apologize, this video is a couple of days late. As you know, I was extremely sick, and I'm feeling a little better, not 100%, but at least well enough to be up doing this video. So we're getting ready to move into chapters 9 and 10, unit 5 of the course. First, a quick word on unit 4. It came to my attention with grading your quizzes, that some of you maybe aren't really reading the chapters, or maybe you're just skimming them and not doing so carefully. There were some pretty glaring inaccuracies on the quizzes. You can go and look at those. I'm not going to talk about what they were, but what they showed me was some real misreadings of the material, and misreadings that I guess could have only come from very, very quickly skimming the materials. And that's problematic because it ended up with some reversal even of the information. And I don't want you guys, I don't mind skimming. Skimming is okay. People do it in life. Professors do it. Students do it. But I don't want that skimming to result in such glaring inaccuracies that it really impacts your grade. So please just be careful. Make sure that you read the materials a little more carefully and make sure that you take some time with the PowerPoints. They shouldn't take that long and it should help to clarify some of the issues that maybe could be misread in some of the chapters. Okay, so unit number 5. This is our last really big unit as far as the books are concerned. You have two chapters, chapter 9 and chapter 10 of Latin American interpretive history, and then also of consider the source. You have a film also. The film is La Historia Oficial. You do not need to go looking for that film. You don't need to rent that film. I have placed a hyperlink to a digitized version of the film in the homework module, so you can access it right there. Just click and watch. So, of course, as a part of these units, you have your quizzes and you have the discussion forum. Your quizzes this time around, you have an option on the quizzes on the chapters. There is an option for an all multiple choice quiz, or there is an option for doing the quiz as we have been doing them, which is half multiple choice, half short answer essay. The reason I did this is I had a number of students comment that they really liked the all multiple choice quiz for the film last time, so I decided to give this as an option this time around. But please be aware, you can only do one of the quizzes. So don't think, oh, I'm going to do the all multiple choice one, then if I don't do well, I'm just going to go ahead and do the other one. I will only accept the first quiz that you take, and a timestamp gets put on that so I know which one you've done first. So make your choice ahead of time, do the quiz, and then that's the one that you get. So what's in these chapters? Chapters 9 and 10, we're getting into again, some pretty controversial material. We're getting in chapter 9 into a time period of revolutions and dictatorships and civil wars and military brutality and guerrilla organizations, all kinds of difficult time periods in Latin America. And this is something we need to be careful with. Because one of the issues that came up on the quiz for chapter 8 was a number of people saying that the United States in 1954 ousted a communist dictator in Guatemala and set up reforms and democracy. And it was actually the other way around. Arbenz was labeled as a communist, which he wasn't, but he was labeled as one by the United States because of his land reforms. And he was overthrown and went into a period of brutal military dictatorship that reversed all of the reforms and was supported by the United States government. He was democratically elected, and we supported a coup to get rid of him and supported military dictatorship after that. And this would happen frequently throughout Latin America in the upcoming time period of the Cold War. So we need to be careful and keep an open mind. We need to keep an open mind about things like the Cuban Revolution. We have this mindset in our country about Cuba that comes from the media and from government information. But we have to think about, okay, so yes, there have been problems of dictatorship and some brutality, but the majority of people have and still do support the Cuban Revolution. And why is that? We have to read carefully to know what it is that changed with the revolution that causes the people of Cuba to generally support it. And this is true in other cases as well. So please keep an open mind. Come to realize that a lot of what was done in the Cold Period was not a matter of democracy versus dictatorship. It was a matter of communism versus capitalism. And our government supported a great number of dictatorships in the name of capitalism, just to go up against what we called communism. Okay, so that being said, that disclaimer. And then in chapter 10, we'll get into a period of redemocratization in Latin America that also came along with its own issues. Okay, so you have your quizzes, chapter 9, chapter 10, and La Historia Oficial, the official story. You have your last discussion forum. So this is your time to shine. This is your last graded discussion forum in the class. We will not have a discussion forum with unit number 6, which is just one quick chapter. So all we'll have with that is a quiz. So this is your last opportunity to get the grades you need for your discussion forum. And then it will be a quick unit number 6 and moving on to your research papers, really focusing. Hopefully, you're already working on them. I will be getting into grading your updates very soon here, but we'll be able to have some more time to focus on them. So let's get going. Unit number 5. If you have any questions, you know how to find me.